Well, hello there. No matter when, where, how you're watching this, good morning, good day, good evening. This is Nogan, your friendly mumbling average gamer. Epic Game Store has been giving out free games regularly, and I'm gonna take advantage of that to try them out, show you some gameplay, and you can decide if they're worth your time and hard drive space to install and play them yourself. From now to January 28th, 2021, Galactic Civilization 3 is the free game of the week. It's a 4X turn-based strategy game. 4X stands for Explore, Expand, Exploit, Exterminate, made famous by the classic game Civilization, which was the first game I ever got with my first computer. I once played the original Civilization 3 days straight, almost no sleep, ate only microwave pizza and instant noodles. Hey, I was in college and I was good. Studied hard and didn't play much during the semester, so I deserve some uninterrupted gameplay during winter break. The good old days. And then there was Master of Orion, civilization in space with the ability to design your own starships. Galactic Civilization seemed to be heavily influenced by Master of Orion, so let's see if it's actually a worthy successor.
You claim humanity causes the destruction of the galaxy. How can this be? Earth is surrounded by an alien armada. Our allies lie in ruins. Their worlds ravaged. I don't see how we could be the great threat in the universe.
There is a crusade coming. A crusade led by humans. And with it, the end of all things.
Okay, pretty cool introduction movie. Is human actually the bad guys? I guess we'll find out, or we can decide if we play the human. So this is the main menu. You can see there are a few different types of games. You can start a new game, which is basically a typical 4X game. You will be able to choose your race and a few different settings, but you're gonna start in a randomly generated map, and you're gonna have to start to build up your faction or civilization. Quick start looks like just a predefined settings, so you can just start right away. There's a multiplayer option. Seems like there are a few games already running. There's a tutorial we can go through, and there's a campaign mode also, which I may try out. Looks pretty interesting. You can also design your own civilization. If you want a race of squirrels, you can do that. That's pretty interesting. All right, let's start a new game. Looks like there's a good number of civilization we can choose from, just from the base game. So these two look like two different types of humans. And there's some non-carbon based life also. For example, we have the Zior Singularity. There's cybernetic beings, so they're basically robots. And so they're actually synthetic, they don't need food. And then there is also something like the Sly. which are second base life. So again, they don't need food either, they just need Promethean to grow their population instead of food. I think I'm gonna pick the Terran Resistance. So they're human, but they are also militant. They can produce ships faster, they're also more resistance to invasion. So they're more militaristic. Are probably gonna be a little bit aggressive in this playthrough. More battles, more fun. Okay, here, so you can pick different settings for your map. I think I'm just gonna leave the standard options. So it's gonna be medium-sized galaxy, normal difficulty, galaxy options, different settings you can change to, you know, change how your galaxy is gonna look like. There's also victory conditions. I'm just gonna leave this on. There are other things you can set up. You can also pick your opponents. I'm just gonna leave the standard configuration, so a lot of them will be random. The ones left behind. The Terran Resistance composed a portion of the human race that was left to fend for itself when Earth was locked behind the Precursor Shield. For years, they wandered the galaxy, avoiding the Drangin and their allies until they found a safe refuge near the far rim of the galaxy, where they were able to rebuild and even begin dreaming of a return to Earth. The years of wandering has taught the Resistance a great deal, and they are now experts at ship recycling, asteroid mining, and operating covertly. Strengths and weaknesses. The Terran Resistance are excellent at making do with limited resources and have become masters at ship recycling. Years of living on the run have also taught them valuable skills at remaining hidden and operating covertly. Okay. Alright, so this is the map. So there's fog of war, so I can only see a limited distance from where my ship and base is. So this is my home world. It's called Refuge. Heavily shielded by a dense magnetic field, very helpful to research and defense. Pretty cool. And I come with a shipyard already, which is good. I can start building ships right away. And I also have a survey ship, TRS Voyager, long-range vessel suited for mapping the stars and running away from things. It has some basic attacks and defense stats, decent hit points, 33, move 3 hacks at a time. This is a pretty good ship. You know, it's gonna be one of my stronger ships for a while until I can develop and build better ships. Before we go too far, let's take a look at my surroundings too. So besides my homeworld shipyard, so Proxima Centauri is the star or sun of the system which my homeworld is located. There is another planet here called Shield, but it's a dead planet. And that's it. Oh, there's one more called Shade. It's also a dead planet. And I'm surrounded by some asteroids. Not much around. Let's take a look at my homeworld. Here is my capital city. Just like any Forex games, there are cities, in this case planets. You will be able to build up, you know, to add different structures, give you different productions for different resources. You're gonna need to build up your armies, develop science, generate money, increase influence in this case. You have to worry about whether your population is well-fed, whether they're happy. All these you manage in this screen, one planet at a time. The first thing I'm gonna do is improve my production. That would increase the rate at which we can build more structures. I'm gonna go with ship constructions and research also. Research is always important because that would help us develop better technologies sooner. I'm gonna build the colonization center here. as you can see, it will receive one all construction bonus from this tile. Okay, built. So it's gonna take 5 turns for it to complete. I can potentially queue up a few more constructions also, but I'm gonna do one at a time for now. Alright, I've shipyard, so let's see what kind of ship I can build at this point. So I can build a colony ship, which basically allowed me to colonize other planets. I can build a constructor, which let me build star bases or shipyards. I can build a scout, which is kind of useless at this point. Explorer, surface ship special, allow us to actually pick up special artifacts or some space debris and get random goodies like credits or experience, even sometimes help us improve our research. Alright, I'm gonna build a colony ship because in these type of 4X games, at the beginning especially, is a little bit of a race for each civilization to explore and build more planets or cities as soon as possible, right? The more planets I can acquire, the more I can build in terms of ships, buildings, and generating more resource for my civilization. I need to pick a research at this point also. This is like a quick screen to show technologies I can research at this point. Or I can go to the tech tree to get a better look at each of the tech tree and see what technologies further down the line on the trees so I can plan ahead a little bit better. I think the first one I'm gonna research is artificial gravity because this will give me additional movement for my ships so I can explore my surrounding galaxy as soon as possible. Afterwards, I'm probably gonna work on warfare to beef up my fleets. Alright, technology, artificial gravity. Let's take a look at the civilization screen. If I have leaders, I can assign them to different aspects of my civilization. So right now, I have one assigned to construction in general. So give me a 6% bonus. As mentioned, I can change my tax rate here. For my home world right now, the approval rating is only 41%. If I lower my tax rate, well, you can see my income is lower too, but approval rating will go up. And here, when I have more colonies, I can actually see them all listed here, so I can go to them quickly. Okay, and I don't have any trade routes yet. Alright, let's send my ship out to explore. Since there's nothing else I can do now, I can click turn or press tap to advance to the next turn. There are a few tabs up here which help me manage my civilization too. I've been looking at the summary tab. I can go to the planet tab to jump to different planets quickly, or I can go to the ship tab, jump to my different ships quickly too. Ah, okay. See, I find some space junks, which I can pick up. Economic relic, increase colony gross income. Build a Xeno archaeology module on any nearby starbase to study this precursor relic. Let me find another planet soon. First anomaly survey. Your survey ship cautiously approaches the mysterious object. All sensors set to maximum gain. A secret of the universe, the first of many, is about to reveal itself to you. Right, this appears to be the remains of some sort of vessel. Within the debris, we find a moderate collection of valuable ship components and rare elements after a thorough survey. Curiosity may often be dangerous, but is also regularly profitable. Right, give me some money and experience point. Cool. Alright, let's check out the other space junk too. Cool. first colony ship is built, so I can determine how many population I can load onto the colony ship. Let's give it one for now. Alright, so this is where my colony ship is, but I haven't seen any planet yet. So let me move my Voyager first. Good, some more money. Alright, so I'll take a little bit of risk and send my colony ship out to explore a little bit too. Alright, let me go north. Or up. Oh, in space there is no up and down, right? Not able to generate gravity, but rather channel it. By doing so, we can make off-world living much more productive. Alright. Let's choose a new tech. Let's mention... I'm gonna go to warfare. So at least I can build some ship with weapons. Space rocket in this case. Oh, shipyard now is idle. Let's build another colony ship. Come on, let me find another planet to colonize. Alright, yeah, my construction went up, that's good. And what else should I build next? Let's beef up my research a little bit. See, the influence of my homeworld just increased. That's nice. Alright. More money is always good. Alright, let's keep going this way. Come on, let me find another planet to inhabit. Meanwhile, precursor relic. New refuge we have discovered, an ancient recording device that appears to have been drifting for centuries. The technology is delicate, but incredibly advanced. What are your orders? Let's use these recordings to make our world a center of influence. Make use of its delicate instruments to help us increase our planet's development for our time. Weaponize it into a ship. So, this is a interesting system in this game. So random events show up like this. You have three different type of options, and each type represent whether you're acting in a benevolent way, or pragmatic way, or malevolent way. And they give you points, and these points will add up. You can actually spend this point on special rewards in each of the area. Whether you choose to be benevolent, pragmatic, or malevolent. So I'm gonna go militaristic, so I'm gonna weaponize it into a ship, because I'm gonna gain a warship. That's pretty handy at the beginning especially. Okay, another colony ship built. Next I will build a instructor, so I can start building starbase. Alright, what ship did I just gain? TRS Battle Axe M0-1. It's a small escort with 11 hit points, 1 beam attack, 6 armor rating. It's better than nothing. It's probably going to be better than most things I can build at this point. Movement's only 2 though, that's a little bit slow. Alright, let me go up. And this colony ship, I'm gonna send it to the west. Again, there's no north, south, east, west polar direction in space, but that's how I'm gonna think for now. All right, let's keep going. Explore. Oh, come on, give me some planets I can colonize. This is only a dead planet. Maybe there is a habitable planet in that system. Let's hope. All right. My computer core has been built. I should probably build the industrial center right here. Well, it would boost colonization center's construction and probably help with the Santium extractor when I actually go get around building it too. Alright. Build. Okay, next turn. First citizen. Katrina Sin from Paititi, Lemuria, has risen above all peers to become a galactic citizen. Now you can train this citizen into an ever-increasing number of specializations that will help shape the destiny of your civilization. Cool. Citizen. Katrina Sin. So I can give her one of the 5 specializations. There will be more as I uncover more technologies. But for now, I'm gonna make her, you know, actual scientist. I wanna beef up my research. Here we go. So finish militarization. I can choose a new attack. All right, next I'm gonna go with defense system to increase the survivability of my ships. Come on, let's grab the goodies. See, good. It actually gives me 15% of my defense system research. Alright. Let's keep exploring. Still haven't found another habitable planet yet. It's not good. Oh, wait. Nah. Another dead planet. No. Alright, Voyager. Please. Oh, what is this? Looks like I just found another race. Arkan. That's their shipyard. Oh no, is it their homeworld? Meanwhile, we've come across ancient artifact near refuge, believed to have come from an ancient precursor civilization. Upon activating it, it has elevated our status and offer to aid us. Transform into a scout ship. Look at its sensor lock to reveal nearby space. Convert it into an army of robot slaves to work on our planet. Alright, make another ship. Alright, Voyager. Here they are. Arkan. What is that? Alright, just a scout. Shipyard. That's their homeworld. It's a pretty good planet. Can I beat them? Defeat likely. Oh, I can definitely beat their scout ship, but not their shipyard. I cannot attack their homeworld yet. I think I need the planetary invasion in order to actually invade another planet. Been quite unlucky. Haven't found another habitable planet yet, besides one that's already taken by another civilization. Alright, cool. Industrial center built. What shall I build next? Maybe I'll build this one. The orchid. As an upgrade, not built. There we go. Nope. Just a Promethean, another resource. Ceiling 1, ceiling 5, ceiling 4. Come on. None of them habitable. Really bad luck here. I don't have a single planet I can colonize yet. Alright, defense system is built. Let's go with planetary invasion. If I can't find another 3 planets to colonize, I'll just take it from another civilization. Ceiling 2 dead. Ceiling 6 dead. Thulium. Oh my goodness. Entire system is dead. Yes! Ah. Oh. Ceiling 3, class 9, good. Frozen world requires extreme colonization. Too bad. That's another technology I need to develop. Extreme colonization. Yeah, I can search. This is pretty handy. Wow. I don't think I'm gonna be able to get to this anytime soon. What a shame. Ceiling 7, also dead. Maybe there's a habitable planet here. Wishful thinking. Alright. Okay, my constructor is built. Let's see. Let's just head in this direction. Because it has thulium, promethium. At least 2 resources here. Although there's a relic. There's antimatter here. Let's head this in this direction. Go, Bomba, go. Few more bombers. Outbreak. Refuge has been overrun by a strange alien norovirus. It rapidly kills about 5% of those it infects, but has the curious side effect of making those who survive profoundly more intelligent. Our scientists have found a means to cure it, but some wonder if we could consider allowing the disease to flourish to take advantage of its side effects. Eradicate the virus, one life lost is too many, regardless of the gain. +20 benevolent, +10% research to affected planet. Quarantine the planet and immunize anyone who leaves. Allow volunteers to relocate there, knowing the risk. +10 pragmatic, +25% research affected planet. -80% growth on affected planet. Never let a good norovirus go to waste. Immunize yourself and your friends, then spread the disease throughout your colonies. That's evil. +20 malevolent, +10% civilization research, -10% growth. I don't want to lose growth on my planet yet. So, I'll pick a benevolent. So now, I just gained 20 benevolent points. So, I can pick an ideological trait. So here, I can spend 10 points on pioneering and get a free fully loaded colony ship. for allows construction of the elevation foundation achievement, or allows the building of a missionary center, which produces a benevolent ideology point every 10 turns, or just get a flat 153 research points. I have plenty of colony ship already, just can't find any planets. You know what? I'm gonna just get a flat research points for now. I want to increase the pace of this playthrough. Done. Oh, what is this? Yes! Habitable world. Yes, yes, yes. Finally. Alright, head over there. Oh, this is Lacuna, that planet. Alright, what should I build next? Natural wonder. Alright, I just upgrade this guy then. Incoming message. An unknown civilization has built the Paxton's Emporium Galactic Achievement. Oh no. We should make the most use of our store credit. Some of our advisors believe that we should lower our tax rates to earn the love of our people, even if that means running at a deficit. Others believe we should rush projects on our planets or in our shipyards so that we don't fall behind alien species that may be colonizing the galaxy while we wait. Others advise that we use the credits to purchase technologies and resources from other species. How you decide what to prioritize will determine if we survive in this next age. Alright. I'll think about it. Alright, Voyager, where are you? Here. Yes. Keep on exploring. Lacuna. Oh, there are two planets here habitable. Finally. Okay, so. Where am I? My other colony ship is all the way on the other end of the map. Okay, which one should I colonize first? Class 9. Good. Class 8, so class 9 is slightly better. But this one has plus 10% production, plus 25% research, and plus 10% influence growth. It's an artifact also. This one only have plus 10% all construction, minus 15% food. It's dimensional mirror artifact. Don't know much about those artifacts, but this one actually seems like better, even though he is slower class. As corrosive lakes and storms make this world unsuitable for colonization by non-carbon life forms. Interesting. You know what? Since this is closer, I'm gonna colonize this one first. Lacuna 3, yes. First colony. Finally, after their long journey, their colonists set foot on an alien world. Until effort and struggle were required to get even this far. But it's only the beginning. The galaxy is filled with worlds for the taking. Sentient planet. Your scientist tells you that there's something strange about this planet. It talks to us, they explained. That's strange. Planets shouldn't do that. Although the planet seems disinterested in your day-to-day affairs, it may be possible to communicate with it further. What are your orders? You begin communicating with the planet. It turns out that the planet is really boring. And all of its stories are about dirt and take forever to tell. Nevertheless, your researchers managed to learn a lot about dirt. Gives me plus 10% benevolent, 10% research. So long as the planet not bothering anyone, it can do what it wants. In fact, let's see if we can find some way to turn this into a tourist attraction. Plus 10 pragmatic, plus 25% tourist income. This thing has been around for billions of years, it must know a lot. Threaten the planet with deep core mining unless it reveals its precious planetary secrets. Gives me 20% research. That seems bad. Really evil. Alright, but gives me more research. And I can probably check out the malevolent ideology traits also. Oh, okay, this is a desert planet. Lacuna 3. What should I build? It has this dimensional mirror. Increase influence growth and maintenance. Ancient wonder. The fame of this ancient wonder can spread your influence and attract tourists. Nice. Again, let's build something. Increase production first. Supply depot. Gives construction plus 10%. Maybe I'll build it right next to my capital. Takes 20 turns. Well, we'll get there. Finally! Oh, another planet requires extreme colonization too. Bacterial world. Oh, darn it. Well, that's an interesting system though. Yeah, by the way, the sun is surrounded by asteroids. Cool. Ooh. Oh, flew past this. Yes, new planet, class 14, excellent. Oh, that looks like a pretty good planet. But, it's like another corrosive world. Well, try it out anyways. Incoming message from Iridium Corporation. Wonderful, a new market. The Iridium look forward to serving whatever you are. We can't wait to share knowledge with you. We're reasonable and open to new deals, open trade. Remain peaceful and we will have no quarrel with you. Harondin Gaul. Share knowledge. Okay, another colony ship built. Nice. So this one should add up. Head over here. Here. Coming message from Iconian Refuge. We once served the gods. We mistakenly thought we were gods and created Yor, who took our homeworld from us. We can't wait to share that knowledge with you. We're reasonable and open to new trades. Space is more than large enough for both of us. Alright. What? This is a trap, isn't it? Let's trade something. I have more money then. And technologies. I should probably get Universal Translator. Travel also. Let's give you money. How much money do you want? Alright. Let's buy two from them. Let's do it. Cool. Oh, AV scale 1. Victory certain. Who are these guys, by the way? Alright, let's check the policy. So, this is me. And everyone in this circle, I guess, are neutral to me at this point. Neutral cordial. This is Iridium Corporation and Iconium Refuge. They don't match the icon of the ship. OAV, people. You know what? I'm gonna give it a shot. Let's fight! Let's see, a war with a player to attack them. They want to declare war on the Africa. Sure. So, we can view battles or do a quick battle. Either way would not change the outcome. You know, just basically watching the animation or not watching the animation. Let's watch. Pew pew! Wait, what? I'm dodging. Come back to me. Come back to me. Take it like a whatever species you are. Yay! Destroy! Victory! Oh. I'm a meanie. Oh, I gained an artifact. What is this? Nanite transmitter. Able to transmit a stream of nanite to any part of the galaxy and instantly construct a warship. Spawn an overlord ship. Interesting. Available charges 1, select any tile to use the power. Huh, that's pretty cool. And I have dimensional mirror. This precursor artifact was left here for unknown reasons. It allows us to see a given area of space in great detail. Review an area of the map. Oh, this is after I inhabited this planet, Kuna 3. And this one, oh, I think it's based because of the upgrade that I built. Cool. You know what? I'm gonna explore a little bit, build a couple planets, and concentrate my ship powers, and then I'll call onto that ship and I'll go beat this guy. Their icon is in red, so they're evil. Right. Red, danger. Let's see. I'll cover these two. I'll see if I can get close to this also. Oh yeah, I can cover all three of them. Just in range, right? Let's see. Construct starbase. Cool. Yep, covers all three. I'm gonna build a mining ring. Archaeology lab. That will cover that ascension crystal. And some defense system at least. Sweet! Alright. New planet. Canute. Canute 3. Water reclamation. A new source of subterranean water has been discovered, which if excess could dramatically help this colony. The water could be used to boost food production or even just people's quality of life. Baths may be possible again, for example. What are your orders? Divert some of the water to food production, but make as much of it available to the people as possible to ease the burden of our colony's onerous water restrictions. Plus 10 benevolent, plus 5% food production, plus 20% approval. We can't be wasteful with this bounty, direct all the water to food production. Plus 10 pragmatic, plus 10% food production. The people will work harder if we can offer extra water as performance incentives. Also, now we can finally afford for people to work up a sweat. Plus 10 malevolent, plus 10% manufacturing. Ah, screw it. Improve manufacturing. I'll build up my Starfleet. Preumbral Beacon Study provides a charge that will spawn a creature from space. What? Like, what, Godzilla? I need to improve production first, as usual. Alright, let me try to build a supply depot here. It's gonna take a while, but yeah, might as well. Ideology, yay! One available, 25 points to spend. Let me get a warship. Let's do this. Where's my new ship? Where's my new ship? Ooh, okay, TRS frigate. No shield though. 4 points in Relgant. 6 armor. It's not that strong. 33 hit points, that's not bad. Alright. Planetary invasion is developed. So I can build military academy, station garrison, transport module. Yes, allow a ship to invade planets. As mentioned, I need to extend the range of my ship, so I'm gonna need something like this. Life support. I can develop that in 4 turns. Let's see if I can buy any of these from one of the other civilizations. Let me try to talk to them first. Can I? Yes, speak. You hold nothing and delight in bringing the goods of universe to those who desire them for reasonable profit, of course. Alright. Do you have anything I want? Oh, life support. They do have life support. Let me just grab this right now. Life support. Do you need anything from me? Defense systems. I'm just gonna pay you credits. There's so much credits anyways. How much do you need? Awesome. Alright, 755. Here you go. Okay, so let's see. Look at that, yeah, see. The range of my fleet increased. So I can potentially just build a star base somewhere around here. And I should have enough range to reach this planet. Maybe I should switch to this tree instead. Work towards this technology so I can increase my logistics. It's gonna be a long way there though. Well, gotta start somewhere. Alright, looks like I'm gonna have a new planet. Lacuna 1. Yes. Funny tasting food. Food grown on this planet has to undergo intense treatment to reduce the trace poisons which permeate the world, a process which results in a distinct taste. Locals don't notice anything unusual, but all 4 visitors find it exceedingly strange and even exotic tasting. Of late, the outside world has developed a fetish taste for this colony's food, and there has been much demand for the export of it. Even to the point of leaving this colony short of food. What are your orders? We need the food more here than elsewhere, though we can at least share the techniques we use to make it so it can be recreated elsewhere. Gives me benevolent influence and approval. Well, let's not do anything to endanger this colony's health, but beyond that, there's no harm in selling any excess food. Gives me pragmatic influence and economy. If it's more valuable elsewhere, it shall be sent elsewhere. Gives me benevolent economy, but minus approval and food production. I'll pick the first one. Alright, this is my new planet. Let me just build this farm upgrade first. Ooh, incoming message from Onyx Hive. What do you want with us, service walkers? We look forward to studying you. Slimur Pitozo. We're reasonable and open to new trades. Remain peaceful and we will have no quarrel with you. Slimur Pitozo. Alright, let's see if you have something I can use. That's a space elevator, but I'm almost done with it anyways. So probably not worth buying from him. Let's talk about something else. I'd like to assure you of our continuing friendship. Yep, let's be friends for now. Oh, I did proclaim friendship with them, so they're unfriendly with me. Better than before. Oh, that's their ship. Ooh. Wow, it's a survey ship. Pretty powerful. 5 total attack, 3 shields, and 34 hit points. My Voyager, I guess it's similar. Alright. Let's keep a close eye on him. Cautious greetings, Terran Resistance. The Taurian regime acknowledges your presence, but trusts you little. Are you monsters, like the dragon, or something better? We greet you in peace. Trust will come in time, Taurians. We're reasonable and open to new deals. Open trade. Remain peaceful and we will have no quarrel with you. Plus, Kizenza. Alright, do you have anything I want? Not really. Talk about something else. I'd like to assure you of our continuing friendship. Oh, with the slime. Look forward to studying you, Rasboon Og. Alright, so let's see if you have something I want. Nope. Let's try to be friends for now. Legions available. Oh, low transport. How many can I load up? 5. Alright, 5 then. That's the transport. You should meet up with the Voyager. Construct starbase. Cool. Mining ring to grab that antimatter. And defense system. Good. Yeah, I think all of my ship should now have range to reach Arkhan. Research done. Choose new tag. More logistic. 7 turns. You know what? Let's get ready. Let's do it. Oh, before I do that, let's use this. I want a warship. Overlordship. Use artifact. Cool. Oh, let's build it right here. First artifact power used. This galaxy has been the home of alien intelligence for billions of years. All things have been invented and forgotten that we have ever learned. But not this. This, whatever this is, will be ours. You issue the command and energy begins to flow through it. Woohoo! 88 hit points. 5 total attack. 6 defense, It's no shield though. Oh wow. 12 logistics though. Ooh, yoy yoy. Okay. My fleet logistics is only 17 now. Yeah, increased by 4. I definitely cannot put a transport ship with it because logistics is 8. I can only give it the smaller ships. All the bombers. Let's do this. All right, let's see if this works. Attack! Oh, invade with populated transport. It's undefended. Huh. That looks easy. Victory! Yay! Spider has no defending legions. Victory is assured. This was much easier than expected. Yeah. The Terran Resistance has taken Aachen from Orphica Enclave. Nice. Attacker casualties. Oh crap. Lost 1,066 soldiers. Defender casualties. They only lost 393. Good, good, good. No building destroyed. The Orphica Enclave has been destroyed. Oh, destroyed the whole civilization. Yay. That was much easier than expected. Well, I guess you get the point. So this is Galactic Civilization 3. Just like any 4X game, Galactic Civilization 3 may feel slow for the majority of gamers out there who are surrounded by fast-paced, action-oriented games nowadays. But if you are willing to give it some time, you'll find a deep strategy game with a lot of customization options, from your species to ships, and tons of decisions to make with consequential options to choose from. And it will reward you if you give it some thoughts to properly plan your actions ahead, while carefully handle any random events which may surprise you. However, the learning curve can be a bit steep, especially for the non-4X gamers. The tutorial is a good place to start, but there are so many details of the game you'll have to figure out when you actually play the game. Make sure you use the search feature in-game, and keep your browser open with Google and Wikipedia, so you can easily alt-tab to it. After a few hours, I feel like I've barely scratched the surface of this game. For Civilization and Master of Orion fans, I think it's worth your time and hard drive space to try it out. If nothing else, it will at least scratch that 4X itch. For gamers from other genre, try it out. You may find a fun and challenging exercise for some parts of your brain which you haven't used for a while. Please let me know in the comments if you'd like to see this game in the series also. If you do you want me to play the same faction or try some alien species? Or do you want me to try the campaign mode? Feel free if you have other fun customization ideas too. Well, ladies and gents, that's it for now. This is Nogan. Thanks so much for watching. You've been wonderful. Stay safe and healthy. Be nice to each other. See you next time.